woman or man who applies for overnight shelter is turned away.
The mayor, a good man, did a lot of good in the city, but stumbled on a very significant issue, and that was the question of homelessness.
Mayor Koch, of course, was the mayor when we first got started. He was a very well-intentioned man, but somewhat difficult to work with.
And I would just invite the mayor to spend some time on the streets and the governor and see how long he lasts in the Palace Hotel. See if he believes his own rhetoric after a night or two in one of the Bowery flops.
Well, I think we embarrassed him because we were one of the few agencies who were doing anything about the question of homelessness when it first became an issue, which it was back during his reign. And he brought people like Gabe Pressman, the news reporter, would bring us up to him and say, Gabe, how come those Franciscans are doing this and you're not? And he didn't like that.
This is the East 3rd Street shelter, hub of the city's program for homeless men. Some are bussed in for meals from the East New York shelter, others from armories opened recently as emergency shelters. And what a place this is. It reeks of decay, of human excrement. There is filth. Many of the clients are dirty. Hardly enough showers to go around. There are fleas and lice. Not enough counselors or social workers. Paint peeling off walls, a sense of desolation and desperation.
We saw a need when we first came to New York that wasn't being met.
Contrast to the city facilities, which City Hall insists are cost-effective, that is, economical to run, there are the private shelters, like this one, the St. Francis Residence on East 24th Street. Just a mile north of the city facility on East 3rd, but what a contrast it is.
Gay Pressman, of course, was still alive, but was another very good newsman for Channel 4 here in New York, and he was a big friend of ours because, again, he discovered that we were one of the few that were offering housing for the homeless. And so he became a big advocate and fan of ours and would feature us occasionally on his show.
A newsman with real integrity. He actually wrote his own scripts. He wasn't a talking head. He actually did his job professionally and thoroughly. And he got involved with us because of this story about us opening up a residence for homeless men and women with long histories of chronic mental illness, and no one else was going near this at the time. And he became a defender of ours and a preacher of ours, even. I mean, he really spread the word and made a big deal about what we were trying to accomplish. He was very impressed, and we were very grateful.
St. Francis of Assisi Church acquiring the building, an old welfare hotel. The residents pay with government funds they're entitled to, kicking in part of their federal disability, SSI, or welfare money for the expense of running the building. Thus, the building pays for itself. And what strikes you first about this place is that it doesn't smell.
What we are trying to do in our residences is, first of all and primarily, provide housing, long-term permanent housing, which is a critical need, not only here in New York, but across the country for this population, at-risk people with serious mental illness. In addition to the housing, which is the bottom line and most important, we do try to provide an array of supportive services to encourage them to lead this dignified life.
Kind of based on the life that we live in the Friary. That's the kind of housing we provide. It's communal living as we live, and it just kind of came naturally to us.
30 days to spend $30 million, a deal that could only be made in a Hollywood script, right? Well, not exactly. A group of Franciscan priests here in New York have been given $2 million by the city, provided they can spend it in 100 days on housing for the homeless. Father John Felice is one of those in charge of spending the money, and he says it is not as easy as it sounds. And good morning.
Good morning.
All right. Now, we should just point out that this money came from an out-of-court settlement with a developer, and the money then, the city decided to spend it on housing. You have been very successful at this, I take it. Why did they choose you?
I think probably because of the track record. We began our work with the homeless, and particularly that segment of the population who has histories of chronic mental illness, back in the 70s, really, which we can get back to later. But we got into the real estate business because of the chronic shortage of housing and the inability to provide any services for these people because they're simply living in the streets. So in 1980, we bought our first hotel, kind of a bold venture for us, and renovated it for 100 people. And then, because we got even bolder, in 82, we did it again. This has 140 people living in it.
But in 1985, it's tougher, right?
1985, it's tougher from the point of view of the properties that we need are shrinking rapidly, and they want a whole lot more money.
Joan London, a lovely lady, this was at the time when about the $2 million. And they come with a limousine to pick you up, and they put makeup on you when you sit down. And the first question was about the $2 million, and my question back was, you know, $2 million ain't what it used to be.
I read in the paper where you said $1 million ain't what it used to be in New York City.
Not at all.
Remember this? Last January, middle of the night, they tore it down on West 44th Street without a permit. To beat the deadline on tearing down those single-room occupancy hotels, havens for the marginal down, not quite outs. Think of the money to be made redeveloping good old Manhattan. In court, the real estate developers made a deal, $2 million, to get off the hook. The city wants to give the Franciscan Friars $2 million to apply to the needs of the needy.
A program that's about dignity, about self-respect, for people who may have been in the streets, may have been in the mental institutions in our city and outside the suburbs, and had no place to go.
This became an international issue. It was on the papers all over the world.
After the demolition of the buildings, the city had sued real estate developer Harry Macklow, and he offered $2 million to settle it. The priests had hoped to get all the money. Three Franciscan priests stood beside the mayor and other officials as Ed Koch announced City Hall was giving them $1.3 million to buy this building on 8th Avenue near 17th Street to house the homeless. This is the eve of Thanksgiving. It's a wonderful Thanksgiving scenario, but these two priests are going into hock.
The give and take back and forth between gay pressmen, you know, and Mayor Koch. They're like two Jewish uncles, you know, arguing all the time with one another.
If this property were appraised at the $2 million, we would have given them the $2 million. I'm not able, Gabe, to take taxpayers' money and to spend it above an appraisal.
We're going to raise it the way we raised it for the first residents and for the second residents, and the way Franciscans have raised money for 850 years, particularly for those who are in need. We're going to go out and beg for it.
The New York Times put an editorial in the paper, editorial saying it's too bad these Franciscans can't get the total $2 million. Essentially, they said that. And some of the people that have given us money before, foundations, et cetera, threw the money at us, so we made up the $750,000 in no time.
On 8th Avenue in Manhattan's Chelsea section, there is a different kind of SRO. The St. Francis Residence offers its 80 tenants permanent housing with support services for only $208 a month. 95% of the St. Francis tenants have had multiple psychiatric hospitalizations. Father John Felice and Father John McVean. They have created a place where Gloria, a 47-year-old recovering mental patient, has been able to put years of shuttling between psychiatric wards and shelters behind her. In December, Gloria will earn her bachelor's degree in psychology from Hunter College.
I've lived many places since I experienced mental illness, and this is the cream of the crop.
I was in and out of places to stay, getting evicted, not wanted here, not wanted there, not been accepted in a decent place to live. Until I came to live with the Friars at the St. Francis Residence, I never really had a decent place to live.
The primary focus of St. Francis Residence is to offer permanent housing with supportive services to homeless men and women with long histories of chronic mental illness. Between the three residences, we have 255 tenants, a terrific staff who worked very hard to take care of this fragile population. And our real job is to keep them out of the hospitals and off the streets.
Do you feel good here?
Oh yes, very comfortable, secure, no problem, no fear of anything. I want to stay here with the folks.
So this is like a family for you?
Exactly, a family.
And, well, he is a good guy, Father Todd. He is a good guy. I mean, when I first came here, you could ask him. I was terrible. I was like, I don't know how to bring it out. I didn't like this, I didn't want that, and didn't want to do this, didn't want to do that. But as I got older, gradually you see what's going on. And I enjoy it now, being able to talk and let my feelings out.
This has been for us a labor of love. And when you work with this population, as complicated as it is, and you see people who've had dealt a tough hand in life, and we have a chance to make their lives better, more humane, to help them with their medications and their money management, and all the things we have to do to give them human lives again, and to have a careful and caring setting. This is a privilege to us, and we have been proud to be part of this. We're just two friars, three, four now, who saw something that needed fixing, and we tried.
Thank God for what you have, for the people and the things that surround you and give you a sense of place and warmth and belonging. Say a quiet prayer to those who might be sleeping on your very doorstep. Yell a little at God. Tell him this should not be. Yell a little louder at your elected officials. Tell them this must not be.